In this video, we're going to be going over the concept of a serial dilution and how to make serial dilutions from a stock solution. Before we get further into that, I want to first take a little bit of time to go over the concepts of molarity. Now, suppose I'm trying to make a 1 mL solution of 1 molar sodium chloride. How do I go about doing this? There's a few key bits of information here that I'm looking for. This tells me the volume of the solution that I want. And then this tells me the concentration that I'm looking for. I can use this information to calculate out how many grams of sodium chloride I need to measure out in order to make my solution. I start with the information given by the volume that I want. Here, 1 mL, I'm going to write it as 0.001 liters because liters is in scientific units. And then I want to take the concentration to figure out how much sodium chloride I need. 1 molar is the same thing as 1 moles per liter. You can already see that now if I have liters and liters, I can cancel out my units on both sides, and I'm left with 1 moles in units. I can't measure in moles though, so I want to convert it even further to grams. This is where I take the information that sodium chloride has a molecular mass of 58.44 grams per mole. And then I can do a similar thing to what I did before, which is multiply this in, 58.44 grams per mole. And again, my units from the top and bottom can cancel out, and I'm left with a unit of just grams, which will give me 0.05844 grams as the final amount of sodium chloride to measure out in order to make my solution. Now we're going to measure out the 0.0584 grams that we calculated on the board just now. The scale that I'm using here has this plastic barrier around it, and that's to prevent things like airflow, which can affect even really small quantities like the ones that we're measuring out right now. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my weigh boat, which is just a little surface that I can weigh my chemicals onto, and I add it to the scale here. You can see that the weigh boat itself has a little bit of mass, which I don't want to incorporate into my measurement, so I'll press the zero button and let it recalibrate itself to zero with the weigh boat on top of it. Now I can take my sodium chloride, and I can slowly and carefully start measuring out little by little, going very slowly to try to make sure that I don't overshoot the value. As I get closer, I want to slow down and give the scale a little bit of time to recalibrate and come to an equilibrium before I continue onwards. And so I keep adding a little bit at a time, giving the scale. As I get closer, I even want to close the plastic barrier to give the scale even more time to calibrate without any airflow going through it. And here you can see now I've got 0.0584 grams, and we're ready to proceed onwards. Now that I've weighed out the appropriate quantity of sodium chloride that I want, I can take the weigh boat, gently pinch it to create a spout almost that I can pour from, and then very carefully pour it into this Eppendorf tube that I've prepared. Now I can take my pipette and pipette in 1 mL of water, because my final volume that we calculated for was 1 mL of water. Close the cap, and then just shake it a few times in order to get the sodium chloride to dissolve. And there you have it. We've created a 1 molar solution of sodium chloride. Now I'm going to talk to you about how to make a serial dilution from a stock solution. We just finished making a 1 molar solution of sodium chloride. I can now take this 1 molar stock solution and make solutions of different concentrations starting from this original one. So for instance, suppose the first one I want to do is what we call a 1 to 10 dilution. What this terminology means is that I will be taking one part of my original 1 molar solution and trying to make it to a final volume of this 10 factor here. In other words, adding 9 parts of a solvent to get 10 parts of your total volume. This will give me a 10-fold dilution, which takes me from 1 molar to 0.1 molar. If I repeat this again using 0.1 molar as my starting point, I can go from 0.1 molar to 0.01 molar. And if I repeat one more time, I get to 0.001 molar, and so on and so forth. Serial dilutions are really great because not only do they allow us to create a logarithmic scale of gradients, which is useful in its own right for many experiments, it also enables us to more accurately create a very, very dilute solution, which would be hard to do if you were starting out by measuring tiny, minute quantities of powder chemical. To demonstrate how to make a serial dilution, instead of using our 1 molar stock solution we just created, I'm going to use this blue dye instead so you can better see what's going on. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start by just taking this solution, which is going to stand in for my 1 molar sodium chloride, and I'm going to pipette that into this first tube. And that'll just kind of be our starting point. All right. So recall that I'm trying to make a 10-fold dilution, in other words, a 1 to 10 dilution. What this means is I'm taking one part of this original stock solution, and I'm mixing it with 9 parts of water. In this case, because I'm trying to make a 1 mil final volume, I'm going to be taking 900 microliters of water, which I'm pipetting into the second tube here, and I'm mixing that with 100 microliters of my stock solution. Now I'm going to close up the cap, give the tube a little bit of a mixing, and then you can see that already, just by doing a 1 to 10 dilution, you can see that the color is a little bit lighter already because it's a little more dilute. I'm going to repeat the process again, taking 900 microliters of water into this third tube and mixing that with 100 microliters from my 1 to 10 dilution that I just did. Once more, I'm going to close up the lid, then give it a little bit of a mix, and you can see that the color has become even more dilute. Now, if this was a 1 to 10 dilution of the original stock, and then I just made a 1 to 10 dilution of that 1 to 10 dilution, what I effectively have is a 1 to 100 dilution from the original stock solution. Again, I'll repeat that one more time. Taking 900 microliters of water and mixing it here into this tube with my 100 microliters of this solution that I just made. So I add in that 100 microliters, again, close the cap, give the tube a good little mix, and then you'll see that the color has become even more dilute. Now, we just determined that this was a 1 to 100 dilution of the original, and so if I take a 1 to 10 dilution of the 1 to 100, what I've effectively done through this 3 series of 1 to 10 dilutions is I've created a 1 to 1,000 dilution of my original solution. In this video, we've gone over the concepts of molarity, how to make a stock solution, and how to make a serial dilution from that stock solution. I hope this video helps, and thanks for watching.